On this week's episode of The Pulse, the SHU community is lending a helping hand.
Get a look into the organization fighting childhood cancer with smiles.
Find out about the perks offered to college students.
And get a sneak peek of the theater arts program's news production. I'm Alana Kladas.
And I'm Isabella Giardina. These stories and more on Sacred Heart's very own monthly news show.
You're watching The Pulse.
From Sacred Heart University in Fairfield, Connecticut, this is The Pulse.
In the midst of the recent attacks in Israel and Gaza, Sacred Heart University held a peace walk to pray and encourage peace around the world. Isabella Fabo has the story.
On October 18th, Sacred Heart University held a peace walk to pray in the midst of the conflict in the Middle East. Guest speakers included Venerable Shim Bo, Reverend Sarah Smith, and President Dr. John Petillo.
Our walk today is a call for us to have the courage to denounce injustice, even as we pray for healing and comfort for those who have lost so much.
The university hoped the walk would bring the SHU community together.
There's so much pain and suffering in our world right now, and it is so important for us as an institution to come together and showcase how much of a loving community we have here at Sacred Heart.
It's such a special thing to come together under God to pray for peace and mercy through God's will.
However, some members of the Jewish community here at Sacred Heart felt differently.
This is something that hits very close to home for me. I'm a Jewish student here at a Catholic school, which oftentimes we feel as though we're a minority, so it's great to see everyone coming together for that. I do appreciate the school putting it together, and I think it was peaceful and spread a great message, but more could have been done to make the Jewish students here on campus feel a little more included.
Despite the Walk for Peace being a call for unity, there was no rabbi or imam present. However, more support can be shown through attending events by clubs like the Jewish Club.
You don't have to be Jewish to go to the events that the Jewish Club puts on. It's really just about either spreading awareness if you want to learn more about what's going on. They do a great job of spreading the facts and also just being there as a support to your Jewish friends who need it right now.
The Peace Walk was a first step in showing the community's continuing support for peace. This has been Isabella Fabo reporting for The Pulse, Fairfield, Connecticut.
These demonstrations for peace are not the only way we can show our support for the victims. There are many legitimate, trusted organizations working to save the innocent lives caught in the conflict that are accepting donations. ANARA is an emergency relief and humanitarian aid organization working to provide water and food to the victims of Gaza. The Palestine Children's Relief Fund is working to provide urgent aid and medical relief to over 1 million children in Gaza. Save the Children organization, located here in Fairfield, Connecticut, is working to provide food, shelter, and other basic essentials to meet the needs of impacted children in Gaza and West Bank.
To support organizations providing relief to Israel, 10Gov is accepting donations for Israelis from the South that go towards meeting the urgent needs for impacted families. An organization called One Family supports Israeli victims and their families financially and emotionally. The American Jewish Joint Distribution Committee is a global organization whose programs are providing emergency support to families, children, the elderly, and people with disabilities in Israel. All of these organizations will be posted on our Instagram account.
These are great resources for the Sacred Heart community to show their support. In dire times, SHU steps up.
That's right, Isabella. Volunteering is a core value here at Sacred Heart, with over 115,000 hours performed by the student body. Isabel Haglin has the story of volunteer students getting their hands dirty in Newtown, Connecticut.
Volunteering is a major part of Sacred Heart University. Coordinator of Community Partnerships and Sacred Heart alum Erin Renderscheid says that there are options for students to volunteer daily.
We have a multitude of students that are volunteering in multitude of different ways. So in the Pioneer Service Grant, you have 450 students volunteering that way. But all of our sororities and our fraternities are volunteering in their own facets. I work closely with our athletic teams also to coordinate some volunteer opportunities with them too, along with different programs on campus with our Global Service Learning Projects, with different professors throughout the semester also. So basically, everybody kind of has their toes dipped in our volunteer service.
Students that volunteer not only get to make a difference in the community around Sacred Heart, but also learn something from their experiences.
It's almost needed, you know, giving of your time. And, you know, it well rounds a person, you know, having something else to do other than you know, your own thing, you know, doing something that might not be in your comfort zone.
The aspect of serving with heart is so important to the development academically, to the development professionally, but also personally. A lot of what I learned outside of the classroom happened on my volunteer opportunities when I was a student. And I always recommend that a student just tries it out. You know, you might learn something new about yourself that you might not have ever expected.
One place many SHU students choose to volunteer at is Real Food CT. Nancy Zychek, board member and master gardener for Real Food CT, says that it has been nice to have the connections with Sacred Heart students and discover why they want to volunteer there.
We try to assess what they like to do. The fact that they chose to come here is a big thing, so we know they don't mind getting their hands dirty. And then whatever jobs, there's always a variety of jobs that need to be done, from planting seeds, preparing the beds, for planting, harvesting, turning things over, getting it ready to put to sleep for the fall, planting a pollinator garden, planting some of the shrubs that we had donated or that we bought through grant money. We have our greenhouse now, so we always have work going on in the greenhouse that needs to be done. Watering, anything.
We are leaving our footprint in this local community in a positive way that continues to be a strong pivotal movement that they rely on. These programs are thriving in a positive way because they are needed, and they're also being a fruitful example of how we can better the community as a whole.
At Real Food CT, the produce that they plant goes directly to people in need.
I just love, you know, being here in this place. I've always had a garden, always planted seeds, and just the fact that we're donating the food to food pantries and we're helping people in need is a big part of it.
Freshman and Pioneer Service Grant recipient Daniel Tyndall believes volunteering is extremely important.
Knowing that I am able to help people in any way that I can and being able to put a lot more positivity back into the world.
Volunteering in the community around Sacred Heart allows students to directly see the impact they are making.
The reality is when you do good, you feel good. And the more that you put yourself out there to do something that's impactful and meaningful that you know going into it, you're automatically going to have a positive experience.
Honestly, I just like being able to give back in any way that I can because I think it's important to always give back to other people and make sure other people are strengthening others and not tearing them down.
For students who are interested in volunteering and making a change, go to the Give Pulse tab under your My SHU account. For The Pulse, I'm Isabel Hagland, Fairfield, Connecticut.
That's not the only way the SHU community gets involved with service. Our reporter, Jack Cronin, attended charity events where children with cancer can live free.
In a world that often seems filled with challenges, there is a shining beacon of hope called Live Free, a charity that's fighting pediatric cancer with smiles. Live Free believes that every child battling cancer deserves to enjoy life to the fullest. Their mission goes beyond treatment. It's about creating moments of joy and happiness for these brave young kids.
I'm Courtney Bragg, and I'm the Chief Joy Officer at Live Free. I have always wanted to do something to help people, and I actually worked collaboratively with Live Free on a specific project that they hosted and got to know Dan and really fell in love with the mission of Live Free and fighting pediatric cancer with smiles. And so when the opportunity arose to be able to work for Live Free, I jumped at it, and I was super grateful that Dan and Katrina decided to take a chance on me and hire me on as their first paid employee for Live Free.
Last week at a recent jamboree in the InSports Center in Trumbull, members of the Sacred Heart baseball team volunteered to play sports with the kids. Live Free organizes a variety of events, from baseball jamborees to golf tournaments and also special trips for the kids battling. These range from pro sports games, trips to different cities, and pretty much anything that Live Free can make happen for these brave kids.
Our main programming at Live Free is called our Moments of Joy, and we do just that. We provide moments of joy to families that are fighting pediatric cancer. So we send them to family-friendly events like sporting events and concerts and theater shows and pretty much anything in between. one thing that is taken from a family unit, not just the child that gets diagnosed, is that sense of normalcy, and just being a family and having fun together and enjoying that quality family time. So we try to put the emphasis back on that. And so one example is we were able to send a young cancer fighter and her family to a Golden State Warriors game out in California. We recently partnered with a hospital out there, which was very exciting for us. And we were able to get her courtside for warm-ups, and she got jerseys and all sorts of swag from the team, got to high-five the team.
This charity is rapidly growing, and for a good reason. If you want to be part of this incredible mission and to learn more about their initiatives, visit their website at livefreetoday.org. Remember, sometimes the best medicine is a smile. From Fairfield, Connecticut, this is Jack Cronin reporting for The Pulse.
When we get back, meet a football player fighting to overcome his setbacks.
And find out how pioneers can build their network. We'll be right back.
The pursuit of truth and knowledge.
Recognition of dignity and worth of every human being.
Promotion of the common good of society.
We're always evolving. Your passions should always change, right? Not to say that you should throw away your old passion. You know, they root you, they make you who you are. If I ever want to progress in life, I know that I have to learn new things, be understanding of different cultures, different backgrounds, different interests.
The lessons I learn at Sacred Heart can help me make a meaningful impact that it will lead me to do work that is good for every single person in the world.
I'm drawn to writing socially impactful pieces because theater, it speaks to broad audiences. They can learn from the piece, or they might sit there and say, I've been through that. Even if it's just one person, I feel like then it was a successful piece.
You are not only going to learn from other students, but you're going to learn about yourself.
I was always asking why, and I saw that with molecular and cellular biology, you go to the smallest detail of that why. In my future path, like, I hope to answer more of those whys.
Welcome back to The Pulse. With the 2023 fall football season quickly coming to a close, it has been a rebuild year for the Pioneers. Starting linebacker for the Sacred Heart defense, Ernest Howard, makes his return to the field after finding a way to bounce back from a season-ending ankle injury. McKenna Wright has the story.
Everybody played their assignment. Ernest Howard, he did his job.
Ern is outstanding athletically. He's very talented. He's fast. He's athletic. He can get from sideline to sideline. He has a great nose for the ball. That's why last year he was named All-Conference, and he missed the last four games with an injury.
In the shadow of impending injuries, collegiate athletes persist fearlessly in their beloved sport, their unwavering dedication to the game outweighing the perilous odds. For one of Sacred Heart University's starting linebackers, Ernest Howard, the 2022 football season was starting out to be one he would never forget. While this remains true, it is for a much bigger reason than anybody could have ever predicted.
I got injured in the Merrimack game, away at Merrimack. Honestly, it didn't feel like nothing really serious, like a regular sprained ankle, anybody would think of it. So I ended up finishing playing that game. I just didn't feel the same. I went to my AT, Ben Batchelor. I ended up sidelining, putting on a boot, and then later that week finding out that I had ruptured ligaments in my ankle, fractured fibula.
The solitude that envelops an athlete after an injury is a haunting reminder of the camaraderie left behind on the field. But for Ernest, this injury didn't just affect him, but his teammates as well.
It hurt, because I think at that time he was leading the team in tackles. I kind of felt like I was out there alone, in a sense. And that's like, at the end of the day, that's my brother. So I wanted the best for him. I wanted him to get healthy, just so I know he could be prepared for the season and for his future in general.
But he does play a position which is high impact. He's constantly getting banged around with, you know, ball carriers and offensive linemen. So, you know, you're going to get banged up and bruised. I mean, you look at DeAndre Bird, he's been playing, he's in his sixth year now here. Same thing, the inside linebackers just take a beating.
With unwavering determination and countless hours of rehabilitation, Earn emerged from the depths of adversity, rising stronger and more resilient than ever.
The process was long, nonstop, really getting treatment every day, twice a day, three times a day if I could. But just really staying consistent on the treatment-wise, it wasn't going to happen overnight. A lot of emotions was going through my head. I obviously wanted to be out there with the guys, but just staying poised, staying consistent to what I know, and just finding a way.
We take care of each other, so we were adamant on him going to PT, making sure he got in 3-4 times a day, just the process, and right? Telling him he has to embrace the process because it happens. You just have to keep going and keep going with the punches, and at the end of the day, everything's going to be fine.
Engaging in consistent action and realizing that some points in life, it can't just be about you. Now it's about repaying the people that invested in you and saw something in you when you couldn't see it in yourself. Inky Johnson. For The Pulse in Fairfield, Connecticut, I'm McKenna Wright.
Here at The Pulse, we like to treat ourselves, whether it's with a donut or a night out at a restaurant, but sometimes it can be hard on the wallet.
I agree, but it doesn't always have to be. Victoria Montori has all the discounts every college student can get. And here's Victoria with news you can use.
Thank you, Isabella. That is right. You can get discounts from local businesses to name brand stores just by being a student. Starting off with shoe discounts, we have Ally Shell Station, Apricot Lane, Best Edibles, Domino's Pizza, Firehouse Deli, Galaxy Diner, Goodfellas Pizzeria, Isla & Co., Mario the Baker, Pliables, Romanacci Pizza Bar, Fazzy's 19th Hole, Main Street Creamery, and Grubhub. Moving on to college students in general discounts, Spotify student subscription is only $5.99 a month, and you can get access to Hulu for free. Apple Music is also $5.99 a month, Amazon Prime is free for 6 months, and after that, it's a discounted rate. YouTube Premium is $6.99 per month with unlimited streaming. Adobe Creative Cloud All Apps Plan is $19.99 a month. Microsoft Office is $2.99 a month. Apple offers education pricing, and Canva Pro is free for all students. At Qdoba, you can get either a free drink with your purchase or get a burrito meal for just $5. AMC Theaters vary in student discounts. You can get free drinks at Chick-fil-A and Chipotle. At Dunkin' Donuts, Taco Bell, Nike, The North Face, Buffalo Wild Wings, and IHOP, you can get 10% off your purchase. At Paramount Plus, subscription is 25% off. At Kate Spade and Adidas, you can get 15% off. SoulCycle is 20% off each class, Levi's is 15% off online purchases, and New Balance is 15% off your purchase plus free shipping. All of these deals will be listed on our Instagram at The Pulse Shoe. So be sure to check it out and start saving. Back to you. Thanks, Victoria. I had no idea we could get so many great deals.
I know, it's awesome, but it doesn't end there. We have even more tips for shoe students. On October 18th, Sacred Heart University's Center for Career and Professional Development hosted a career and internship fair. Exclusively for SHU students, the event hosted over 50 employers. For students who couldn't attend the fair, don't worry. The Center for Career and Professional Development has recently launched a new platform, Pioneers Connect, a website that allows current SHU students and alumni to network and connect with each other. This platform is a great way for students to advance their job and their internship search. In addition, the center hosts a variety of events throughout the year. All upcoming events and information can be found on their website.
After the break, get ready to take a ride with the Theater Arts Program's news production.
And we'll introduce you to some of SHU's biggest Swifties.
Welcome back to The Pulse. The Theater Arts Program is packing an entire amusement park into the Little Theater this fall. Victor DiPiero has the story of their new musical.
Every year, the Theater Arts Program at Sacred Heart University puts together a fall musical of high caliber. But this year, The program is bringing audiences a refreshing new story that is sure to be an entertaining one right in time for Halloween. Ride the Cyclone follows the story of six teens in a choir as they lose their life in a devastating roller coaster accident. Now in the afterlife, they'll have a chance to prove why they should get the grand prize from the amazing Karnak, a chance of life once again. Junior Sean Ryan is one of the actors in the show and has done a great deal of work leading up to opening night on October 26th.
Hi, my name is Sean Ryan, and in the musical Ride the Cyclone, I play Ricky Potts.
My character Ricky, on Earth, doesn't have the power of speech, but during the musical, he finds new abilities that he is able to use. And I think I just really enjoy finding new things about the character because it helps me find new things about myself that I haven't known about myself. So, yeah.
The choir is comprised of six Sacred Heart students. Ride the Cyclone gains popularity through an outbreak on TikTok back in 2020. And the hashtag Ride the Cyclone holds over 361 million views on the app as of October 2023. Ever since then, the show has caught on like wildfire for younger audiences, and Sacred Heart is making history by becoming one of the first universities to produce it. Junior Juliana Balzano outlined how she thinks the story is unique, and why it is such a great opportunity to grow in her craft as Sacred Heart has taken on the challenge of producing the show.
I think that Ride the Cyclone is a really good show to put on here at Sacred Heart because it's kind of showing us how you could take so much for granted and it could be taken away from you in an instant, and you need to live in these little moments and make these connections with other people and just enjoy your time here while you can.
Sacred Heart ad campaigns have been spreading around campus as well. With the show having a heavy use of projection and images, the cast had the chance to go film at an amusement park. And that proved to be a brand new experience for the actors.
My experience working with the other five cast members has been amazing so far. Everyone is like so supportive of each other, and we all just kind of sit down and have moments away from being on stage as well, which is really nice. And we just have a lot of fun behind the scenes, like during rehearsals, after rehearsals, anytime. And we've all bonded really well, and I'm so excited to see where we go.
Ride the Cyclone will be taking place for 2 weekends. October 26th to the 29th, and November 2nd to the 5th. All tickets can be found on the Edgerton Center website or in person at the Shoebox office. From Sacred Heart University in Fairfield, Connecticut, this has been Victor DiPiero, The Pulse.
Wow, that sounds like it's going to be a very exciting production.
I agree. Sacred Heart is always finding ways to entertain the community.
And that's exactly what they did with Taylor Swift Night. Senior producer Isabella Gatos is going to talk about a lot of people's favorite topic. Isabella?
Thanks, Isabella. What a great name. Legendary singer-songwriter Taylor Swift took over last summer with her highly anticipated Eras Tour. To celebrate, Student Life hosted the Eras Tour, Sacred Heart's version. So, Pioneer Swifties, are you ready for it? One of the most successful female musicians is currently in her performing era as she headlines her sixth concert tour, the Eras Tour, paying homage to her 10 eras of albums.
Do a show with like all the albums in it. And I was like, yeah, it's gonna be called the Eras Tour. See you there.
The 146 show tour started in March 2023 and is set to end in November 2024. Making it one of the longest running tours in history as ticket sales increase due to tourism across 5 continents. According to The Messenger, Taylor Swift's Eras Tour, with potential $80 billion impact, will have a direct economic impact equal to that of at least 55 Super Bowls and $4.1 billion into her bank account. On Saturday, September 16th, Sacred Heart University Student Life Office brought the Eras Tour to the Chapel Quad. Students dressed up for a costume contest, made friendship bracelets, entered a raffle, and danced to their favorite Swift songs as they paid tribute to her famous tour.
I had the best experience when I went. I went to the MetLife show, and it was just such a sense of community. And because she is so big, because people couldn't get tickets, and also because there's such a community here, I figured that even if you weren't a Taylor Swift fan, like there was a basis here for that.
Actually, didn't get tickets to see the Eras Tour, but
I felt like Taylor Swift, we see through the friendship bracelets and like so many other things, how she brings people together. And I just feel like she brought such a sense of community in her concerts. And I just felt like that was a really great thing to bring to campus because it brought a bunch of people together.
As Swift's fan base is called Swifties, she is worldwide popular as her music is relatable to younger generations, and her philanthropy combines her generosity and talent on a deeper connection. This past summer, the Karma singer gave raises up to $100 million to about 50 truckers carrying her tour across the country.
So, obviously Taylor Swift is the biggest person in the world right now. And you said your daughter went to the concert and all. So, on a musical professional perspective, why is she so big in the world? How is she so influential to basically Gen Z like me, and I'm assuming your daughter as well as part of Gen Z? Why is she so influential to us?
So I think that she writes songs that are very easy for people to relate to. They touch on topics that affect people, and they're extremely personal. And I think that she tells stories in a way that people find really easy to relate to, and they empathize with it. And when you hear something that you really feel you connect to personally, it makes you feel like you're not alone. It makes you feel like there's someone who gets you, and it draws you. I think her project re-recording all her own songs to actually own the rights to her recordings,
yes, definitely,
is like revolutionary in the recording industry, and I think that's something that's going to have an impact for everybody.
I made it very clear that I wanted to be able to buy my music. That opportunity was not given to me, and it was sold to somebody else, and so I just figured I was the one who made this music first. I can just make it again.
Yeah.
So that's what we're doing.
The Cruel Summer singer released a film of her concert, Taylor Swift, The Eras Tour, globally in theaters October 13th. Directed by Sam Wrench, the movie recaps Swift's tour over the past year. As the box office earned $100 million in pre-sale, the New York Times says that AMC bolstered its ticket server capacity to handle traffic at more than 5 times the current record for the most ever tickets sold in an hour. As Swift holds the music industry on one shoulder and her NFL heartthrob on the other, she continues to make the most influential impact out of any artist in 2023. There's a rare chance to get tickets to her tour worldwide next year. Good luck, and back to you.
Thanks, Isabella. Well, that's all we have for you today. Thanks for watching, and make sure to tune in to our next episode of The Pulse. I'm Isabella Giardina.
And I'm Elena Cletus. We'll see you next time on The Pulse.